Hello there. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about memory allocation in Go. So more precisely, I'm going to show you two methods on how to allocate dynamically sized arrays. I will also show you why it's actually useful and what happens if you don't do it the right way. What are the errors you can encounter? So I'm going to show you that right away with some examples. Here we go. Let's create a program. Go code test.go as usual, package main, func main. There we go, let's open it. We want an array, so let's declare my array is equal to it depends on the size. I will decide. Let's put the size here. Size is going to be 10. So the array I'm going to get will depend on the function that creates the array. So let's create array of size and let's put the size here. And in the end, let's print it. Print ln my array. There we go. Now we need to create a function that actually makes that function. So it's size 10. So let's create it from create array of size. So it takes size, which is an int, and it will return a slice of int, an array, and there we go. So right now there is just one that you can do. Let's fill that array with numbers from 1 to 10, for example, to make this more interesting. So the variable, the answer, which is an array of int, and it has to be of size 10. So I can put the 10 here, for example, or I could use a size. But for now, I'm going to do it this way for demonstration purposes. So for, I'm going to fill it with numbers from 1 to 10. So there we go. Answer of I is going to be equal to I plus 1 every time. And then I'm going to return the answer. And this should do it. Let's keep some space here. Voila. The return of the answer is not working because it's expecting a type 10 int. So here I have to put a 10 in this case. So there you go. Go run. Go. This appears. This program works the way I intended to. So there you go for now. It's working for a size 10 slice of int. But now let's say I just want the first 5 ones. So what do I need to do? I can put a 5 here. And then what will happen? Go run, does that go? I do have the table of 5, but I have 5 spots that are wasted, 5 memory spots that are wasted. So what happens if I put more than 5? Let's put 11. One more than 10. Let's see. Now a mistake happened. So now I don't have enough space. And how do I make this dynamical? Like, maybe first instinct would be to put a size here. And remove the 10 and just hope this works. That's it. As you can see, there's a mistake already happening. Non-constant array bound size go. It doesn't want to run it. With my linter. Non-constant array bound size. So, how do we make this dynamical? There's two ways. The first one is that you use the make method. So, let me show you what I mean. Size int equal make a slice of int with the size. This will actually work. You don't need this anymore. You can put this way. And there you go. Now it's going to be dynamical. Go run test.go. 11. If I put a 5 here, this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it actually works dynamically the way you intended to. That's one of the methods. Another one is to use append. So here, instead of allocating the whole memory space from the beginning of the function, we're going to increase the array with one action by one action at each iteration. Let me show you what I mean, because it's definitely not clear. So, var the answer an int without anything, it's an empty one. So we've seen that this doesn't work. So here, instead of this, we're going to answer. It's going to be equal to append answer. I plus one. This will work the same way. In theory. Let's try it. It works. This works as well. And this as well. Two ways to do it. Make does it in one action, and append allows you to do it in many iterations. In this case, you can actually change the size of an already existing array. So one is more efficient than the other in some cases. I will let you discover why. And that's it for now. Thank you for watching.